Hi guys, welcome to this quick tip about how to solve crime issues. Well, this is not going to be a short video. So if you want a quick tip how to solve it, you can press CHE, and go to your menu and go to your debug functions, and here you can reset citizens crime level. And then all criminality levels are set to zero and you're happy to play again. That's not what this video is about. That's also not what I want to explain to you. I want to explain to you how you solve your, how to truly solve your criminality rate. In this map, we are talking about 12% criminality rate, which is huge, which is very, very much. And we can also see this because our police station is overwhelmed with all kinds of cases which are never going to be solved. They're trying to solve, maybe this one will be solved, but you know, it's a how do you say this, water to the sea or something. So what's happened here over the years? The criminality levels have gone on and up, and the police station wasn't able to cope. What I want to do in this video is to explain to you how loyalty and criminality level and how productivity rate, how this all fits into each other and how to solve this. And I want to do that by kind of start to solve it. And as I'm building buildings, I will explain to you step by step what I'm doing to get this criminality rate down. So, first of all, Kiemnov. Because of the high criminality ratings, we're having a low productivity, relatively low for this republic. There's also productivity levels of 120, which is a lot better. If we have crime and justice, we have police stations that these have to be here, but courthouses and prisons are for the whole map. So what we're going to build some extra police stations, because what's happened now, your entry to the cases which are brought by into the police station depends on the number of police cars you have. And so in this case, the police station cannot handle these numbers of cases. Maybe if they would have had a working productivity level of 120, they would have been able to keep up. But once the police station cannot keep up anymore, the bubble kind of becomes bigger and bigger and bigger. So that's exactly what happened here. So what we're going to do, I want to divide these cars over four police stations, because we have a huge backlog now. Okay, so I want to build those pretty quick. That's why we are on auto build here, and F1, turn you around a little bit, like so, and build a police station here, and let's go, and then build one here, here maybe, come on, like here. And maybe also add some footpaths real quick, so that people can kind of reach the police station here as well. So here, you know, I'm trying to do this quick. Normally I wouldn't build this way, but there's always room to improve. And the last one, where are you? Here. I want to put here. Go away with your savings, and like so, a little bit like this. Okay, and so those are in. Okay, play. So those are built, and now I want to have these cars, divide them over the police stations. And, go, you there, and you there, and the last two, go. You go here, and you go there as well. I need to set that you're buying fuel. And here as well, buy fuel. And here. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we are going to delete all these cases, because there's no fixing these, and I want to start with a clean plate. So I will start deleting this, and you will see that this won't change. I will cut the video and try to work on my RSI a little bit. So those were easily 600 cases, I think, but now we have removed everything. So what we now have effectively done is we are all the cases that are coming in are going to be divided over these four police stations. This one will get the most because it's in the center of the city, so the cars can go up and down way quicker. So Kaimaya, you say build some more police stations and then we're done. Well, no. What we have effectively done now, we have created a whole new problem, an extra problem, which is there are going to be a lot more cases. And so from the police, the cases go to the court, and from the court, they go to the prison. So our courthouse, which is here, let me show you a little bit about the map. Very shortly. This is the first city is Bremsky. Here is Majatsol, and this is this city. This is Kiemnov. Those are the three cities. Majatsol and Bremsky are perfect cities, criminality wise, and there's no issue there. So we are going to want to build an extra court, and because the courts are going to be overcrowded with cases. So where would you want to put a court? Here, right, where all the criminality is? Well, no, because the productivity here is the lowest. It's 82% now, and here we have 117, and we're going to Bremsky here, and where's Bremsky? Here we have, oh, I need to build the city hall, which I did, I thought. But there are no people working. Yeah, now there is. A productivity rate of 121. So ideally you would add the courthouse here. Only I wouldn't know where, because it's a pretty big building. Where are you? Here. Pretty big building. So there is literally no room. So that's why I'm going to build it in Majatsol. And I was looking, and I'm going to build it here. So, two courthouses. Go fit, thank you. And footpath here. Okay, excellent. Play. Okay, so now the cases are going to be divided over this courthouse and the courthouse here. And I think you will see that it's already increasing. Now the limitation is 1, 2, and 3%, but that will change. So once the and also here the people working here, the judges here, their productivity rate means that the cases here will be fixed earlier than in Majatsol and way earlier than it would have been in Kiemnov. So now we are going to have to decide about the crimes and the sentences. We have one prison here, which is when I started had one prisoner and now two, because they have been they have been trialed and they have been sentenced. I mean, we have one prison here, which is a bit busier here. So what do we see here? Well, for instance, what you see here are the prisoners, and these are the prisoners who are the closest to the end of their sentence, and here are the prisoners who are just new. And you, we can see here some of the prisoners here. We have one of 89% criminality rate. Wait a minute, here. 89%. So how does this work? Here we have a prisoner who is who currently has a criminality level of 82%. Has served a sentence of 0.8 years of 4.6 years. What is happening is every 0.1 year, this footprint is being imprinted upon the prisoner. So that would mean that she or he still would have this footprint imprinted 38 times. Or 46 minus 8 is 38. So 38 times 4.29 is way too much for this prisoner to be healthy and to be released into our cities again. So that means we can decrease our sentences. And you know, you can see a few of these people like that. But what's also happening is our government loyalty. Let me show you. Let me show you for real here. Is 61, 67, 68%. And those are the people who are working here. But here are also people working with a government loyalty of 40%. So if we would increase this, this was again 60%. So if we can increase it to at least 60%. And even 65%, because this is the average loyalty here. Or in the vicinity, because these flats are in the vicinity of the prison. So increasing that, and that we will have to press play now, because the people working here won't instantly have a bigger loyalty level. We should see that this will gradually increase, and so we are even able here now. It was 5.24%, and so you will see that 5.22, that this is increasing. So the bigger the loyalty, the bigger the change in the upbringing level, the less time a prisoner has to spend in prison. What you can also do to increase this even more is say here, for instance, well, we only allow citizens to move into the building who have a big loyalty level, and then we can say, well, you work in the prison, but it's not enough a prison for 430 people, so have go away, have two other places, and say 50% ish in the prison. Okay, so we're going to let this play for a bit, and well, we are going to see this. This will increase because the loyalty level here will increase. So we can decrease the sentences as to not to overburden our prison. So that we can do in our courthouses. Here we can say, well, the 0.7 year, yeah, I can imagine 7 times 5%, 35%, at least you would want that. 1.6, 16 times 5 is already a 75% decrease in criminality. So we can kind of lower that. And 3.9, that is 40 times 5. It should be, the highest should be like 20. That is, and probably lower, but let's leave it like this. So what you're going to see now, that here in Kiemnov, where am I? Here. These police stations are having the majority of the crimes right now. And they are dividing it in solving that, but they are keeping up. You can see the chance to solve 95%. This is the wrong police station. This needs to be pretty high. If this goes below 50 or something, you are you need to build another police station. And we're having all the police station to only have two vehicles. So our productivity level was 82, and now we already see an increase here, and the productivity level also dropped because I dropped all the cases here. That was also an issue, but that's how it works. So, and then for loyalty, we want to increase the loyalty as much as possible. And for that, we have a TV station here and we have a radio station in Bremsky. But here our government loyalty is set to 40%. Can we increase that? Well, we can kind of show what the loyalty is. Well, it is a little bit higher. So I think if we would go to 50%, that would be okay. And we can also focus more on, I don't care for sports, but focus more on propaganda to increase our loyalty. So, ish, this would be fine, and go to the cinema or something. But this will also increase once we are getting some more loyal people here. So that's one. Then we are going to the radio station here in Bremsky. And this is a small radio station here, yes. And so we are seeing that here the government loyalty is 30%. And so overlays, it's much bigger, much better. So we are going to increase this. Where was I? Just show me the overlay. Thank you. So it's 70% average. So you could kind of increase it to 80%, because 70% is an average. So if we have this one and you hover over the people, 43, 75, 81, there are people which are having 85 or so, 84, who have an 80% loyalty. Those people we want to be working here. And so for this, I think this is for now for this radio station, because it's a small radio station. So your rating is never going to be 70-80%. So this is only, you can only influence a little bit with this radio station. And we can also increase the loyalty of our prisoners. It's the same 75, I think. Okay. So now let's look at cases. Well, we are not overwhelmed yet. What I'm going to do, I'm going to have this run for a month or something. And then I'm coming back to show you what the current status is. So see you in a bit. So it's now about a month later, and I wanted to show you what is this to our loyalty, because we started at 67, 66, I believe, and in a month it's already 10% extra, and so I could increase the loyalty here as well. What I forgot to tell you is a prison year. Here, let me have a prison year. Let me take you. Prisoner. Prison year is about a month in game. So the technically boils down that in every 3 days this footprint is imprinted upon the prisoner. So every 3 days this criminality level will decrease 4% in this case. But I wanted to show you what is this to our criminality level in Kiamnov. We are seeing here as well that we are having the longer sentences here, but if you look here, we are already seeing the shorter sentences. So the prisoners will be less overcrowded. Also, our little trick on having these people work there, I had to give them some more workplace. There's still a lot of unemployment here, but that means, let's pause a little bit, that these people, let me give you some example, 131 productivity, 137, 134, these are very productive people now in the prison, which makes this Fort Knox. So you also see no one escaped. Well, I regularly see that it is not fully staffed. So there's that. And we're going to Kiamnov here. Kiamnov. So what did it do? Well, we had a criminality level of 12%, and now we see it's already going to 9%. I have let it run until October. In my test, and then the criminality level went down from 12% to 6%. So I do expect more and more that the criminality level decreases, and therefore the loyalty level rises and the happiness rises. And so this is how you fix Kiamnov. Now for the police station, because yeah, we have 4 police stations. I thought, well, you know, these are only 3 cases and they're less here and less here. Let's get rid of 1 or 2. And at one point I had this one and this one. So I wasn't looking, and suddenly this one was overcrowded with cases. So I would advise you to leave them up for at least a year. I mean, we don't need workers. We have unemployment for at least a year until there is some stability in the cases. And also I want to show you that our court system, well, it's now getting a little bit overcrowded, but let me pause a little bit. What you see is the length it takes for a trial depends on the seriousness of the crime. It's like if this would take 100% of the time, the medium crime would take 200% and a serious crime would take 400%. And that's how you also see how these crimes are solved. If you get to a limitation of like 50%, and you see that in the green crimes, then it's time to build another courthouse. Courthouses deal with 15 cases at the same time. If you see that this you can also see in the police stations, there you can see that if this gets overcrowded, every crime gets dealt with. There's not, we're first dealing with the top 10 crimes or something. So that's the difficulty. If your police station gets overcrowded, the crimes don't get fixed because they are dealing with every one of them. And so that's also, I think, why this suddenly can get too many cases. So how, I think you're still at 9%. Yes, but we are seeing that with those extra police stations and the courthouse, we didn't need to build extra prisons. Also, obviously, because we shortened the sentence time. And what you see here is that the criminality level of the prisoners who are leaving the earliest is 0%, and that's what you're after. So I hope this little guide was helpful in solving your crime issues. I don't mean to say that that this is 100% how it works, but this is how I have understood the whole loyalty, productivity, criminality level, and how everything fits into each other. I hope you enjoyed this video and this quick tip. Have a nice day. Bye bye.